We should prepare for...
Ah, fuck.
Thank you.
Checked our food stores and it looks grim. We lost. frequency of this video, the more it scares the shit out of me.
Fuck off.
We have prepared for it.
Oh, fuck off.
Thank you.
boom. Fuck. I was completely fucked. It didn't matter.
We had prepared for any disaster, for every disaster. Not all of them at once. We can't turn back, but how can we go on?
All right. Damn it. Oh, whatever. All right.
Moods are turning sour.
Oh, come on. Thank you. Good start. Fuck! God damn it. Well, this is fucked. Damn it.
We have prepared for any disaster. For every disaster. Not all of them at once. We can't turn back, but how can we go on?
That was about right.
Designed for the Ektomi. Of this video, the more it scares the shit out of me.
Damn it.
fear get the better of me, but... foods. A transmission arrived. Not from Earth, but from Mars. From... That suit.
He only had 3 deaths. Fuck me.
I see this video, the more it scares the shit out of me.
Any sense.
We've almost made it. After all we've been through, there's no turning back. It's a suicide mission.
We had prepared for any disaster.
Thank you.
Wheatley.
We had prepared for any disaster.
Oh. One more run.
We have prepared. Thank you.
had prepared for it.
After the virus hit, New York fell apart in a few days. Now, we each have a role to play in this fight to save what remains. With every battle won, we become stronger. We will put this city back together. When society falls, we rise.
Content first on Xbox.
Did you know that they've been making video games since the 1970s?
The 70s, you say?
The 70s! Jason A. Stryker.
Hi. How are you?
Good.
70s. I was born in that decade.
So was
Me
I.
Too.
Really?
Yeah, I made it.
Damn.
Yep.
I squeaked in.
Yeah.
It's been a good decade.
Yeah.
I don't necessarily remember the 70s being popular for video games, but tell me about
More like vodka and cocaine.
Which is the game in and of itself.
Those were the big things.
But those are pretty timeless.
That's a fine recreational.
They kind of never go out of style.
Disco?
Sure. Disco. Duck. Eschers.
Yeah.
In a sense.
I had a disco duck album. As a cover to our buckets, because we didn't have plumbing out on the farm.
Wow.
So my disco duck album covered up the poop bucket.
And.
That's an appropriate use of Disco Duck.
Wow.
Yeah, that's absolutely appropriate. A lot of games have been made since the 1970s, including the one we're going to play today on the old game show.
I'm wondering where you're going with that.
We were originally going to play some Super Mario Maker.
Yeah.
So what happened exactly? Their servers are down for the week.
Is it just the Mario Maker servers?
Yes. Or? Yeah. They're down for something, maintenance. I don't know. Oh, something freaky going on. Who knows? Yeah. So I had been thinking about playing this game for a little while now. We had talked about it. We flirted with the idea for a while, and depending on how it grabs us, I've got a few games here pulled, but we might just play this first one for the entire show.
Okay. I would be down for that.
I'm guessing both of you guys have played this game
before. Yeah, this is actually one of my favorite games. It's a little tough to go back to, but it was very influential to me.
This feels a little bit like a special occasion to me, because I have been thinking about checking this game out since the mid-90s when it came out.
Yeah.
Never sat down and looked at it.
Yeah, I played a little bit of it at some point last year, just to get a feel for it, and decided, like, okay, I need to stop playing this so that we can play it here.
Good.
And so I have it here. Are you ready for this?
Yes.
All right.
Excited. Thanks. I'm late.
Here we go. It's Phantasy Star Online of the 90s. No.
I'm a little bit nervous.
All right. It's from the next generation platform known as the Sega CD.
This is not the startup music that I'm familiar with.
Look at the scaling and rotation on the sprites.
Yeah.
Really.
That is, they changed the music in a couple of different areas over time. And this game is called Snatcher.
Oh, it's got this. Yeah, this is from that era when this was the logo.
Yeah,
that's Castlevania 4.
It's a Konami game.
16-bit Konami intro.
So I'm going to need money from all you guys to put into the slots so that we can play this.
Okay.
I never change this. I always just choose whatever defaults.
Hold the phone. Hang on.
I don't know which one's highlighted.
I want to know what's going on here. So the top one is the second Sega CD.
Yeah, it is.
Yep. What the hell? Did that thing have more RAM than the first version? What's going on here?
No, this is just where you want your save to go.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, okay.
You know, okay, this is just like where you want to store your save.
Okay, I thought this was some kind of RAM expansion, like in 64 style or something.
No, no. This is a cyberpunk adventure.
For cyberpunks.
Mm. Like ourselves here. This game had support for the Menacer, or maybe the Justifier.
Was it Justifier?
Yeah, the Konami had their own gun, but maybe it also worked with the Menacer, I don't actually know. Because there's shooting involved. You can draw a blaster, you can cancel, you can select shoot.
There is shooting involved.
Yeah, so we're going to stick with joypad only, because I don't have a gun.
I forgot mine today.
Yeah.
I usually bring it.
Okay.
I don't know if I believe this.
It's an entire coincidence. If there's anything here that's similar to real people. I don't know if I believe this.
Roland! Man!
In some parts. This is the English version for the Sega CD. This game was released in a handful of different places.
Oh, man.
And it is dedicated to all the cyberpunks who fight against injustice and corruption every day.
That's you.
Of their lives.
That's you.
You.
Yeah, this dates back to 88 when it was first released.
Yeah.
1988.
Wait, really?
There was a PC Engine version. There was, the MSX version.
There was the PC 88 version first.
For development there. Is released into the atmosphere, creating a deadly biohazard. Lucifer Alpha spreads throughout Eastern Europe and Eurasia.
Lucifer Alpha.
80% of the populace. The world's people die. The greatest biohazard in history later becomes known simply as the catastrophe. But at this time, who could have possibly imagined that the ultimate biohazard wouldn't occur for another half century.
It got worse.
50 years later,
Biohazard 2
faces its greatest crisis. The appearance of a mysterious android life form. Its purpose and origin are unknown.
Little skeletons.
Oh, this music is good.
Oh, yeah, one of the former
perhaps an invasion from.
Oh, I've seen that.
The cybernetic skull looks like a real idiot.
I've seen this screenshot so many times.
The place of their victims. Employing an artificial skin, they can sweat and even bleed. Hot or
skin job.
They're almost impossible to distinguish from.
So this is just Bubblegum Crisis. This is just Blade Runner.
This is Kojima. Yes, I'm Blade Runner.
Okay.
Watch some Bubblegum Crisis.
Okay.
And maybe
these mysterious invaders become known as Snatchers.
Oh.
Hey guys.
Shoots
It's like Space Harrier.
Yeah, he shot Space Harrier out of his mouth. He threw up Space Harrier at us.
So, in like, the original Japanese versions, the eye was all red. It had, like, red trim. It looked even more like a Terminator. They changed the...
Oh, the art shape? Yeah. Which one did you play first?
Sega CD version, which is near to my heart. It's one of the better ones. A little censored from the original Japanese versions, but then they came out with, like, untranslated, like, a PlayStation and a Sega Saturn version.
Okay.
And those, like, went black and white in some of the gorier sequences and stuff. Like, those were even more...
It was weird, and they straight up, like, blurred one gory sequence in it. Like, that was supposed to be disturbing.
There's some nudity, too, right?
Briefly,
I feel like I remember there being a shot going around back in the 90s of, like, a boob.
Yeah, there was, yeah, one of the snatchers.
In the context of, like, ah, look how edgy games are in other territories.
But,
look at what they're not showing you.
There was a shower sequence with, one of the characters, like, daughters. Mm. And you, like, walk in on her, and she's like, ah, I'm showering, I'm nude and stuff. So in the original game, she was 14.
Okay.
So they changed her age.
Good.
Kind of cut the lead a little bit. And also there was a... I guess there was a sequence. I haven't played the original, like, MSX version, but there was, like, a...
Metal Gear, Lucy Childs.
Oh, of course. You could sniff some panties as well. That was taken out of subsequent.
Ooh, real.
Because Smell-O-Vision had not been... Consoles were not.
Someday, like, yeah, but maybe the next PlayStation. Maybe that's what Kojima's working on now, panty sniffing simulator, to really take advantage of where tech is at these days. That's why they had to go on that tour, him and Cerny.
Right.
To go around and find the latest tech.
The oh my god, this brings back some memories, man. It's been a while since I've booted this up.
Fucking cyber knife fighting in the streets. That guy just looks over and goes, fucking whatever.
What year is this set, did they say?
2044?
2044? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, sure. The inventor.
Yep. Couple cyber cars. Just style.
Yep.
Just the motherfucking style all over this game.
This game, yeah, particularly resonated with me. Blade Runner for the first time a few years before this. So I'm like, damn, this Blade Runner, that's awesome. And it's also one of the first instances in which I had, like, voice acting in a game.
Ooh.
Yeah. So it resonated with me particularly.
Saxophone is what's resonating with me.
So I'm curious, like, what would you consider this game to be a genre of?
Well, I can't really say it's a scene for it.
Just based on what you...
I assume it's like an adventure game.
Sure.
It's good.
How's work? Everything okay?
Jeremy, what is it? What's wrong? It
scares the shit. Jamie, I've become a junker.
Junker?
No. You're rocking the Gillian.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
It's the only way...
It's got a little bit more going on the sides.
Sure.
Snatcher is the only word that keeps coming back every time we try to remember our past. I have to face them to find out why.
Yes, but I can sense that there is something terrible hidden in our past. And if we remember it, it will destroy us.
Subtitles being turned on?
No, probably not.
Okay.
So is that his sister or wife?
Okay.
But
3 years.
They don't remember each other?
Right.
So they're like, I guess we're married?
In the Siberian neutral zone by the 17th Siberian Investigative Force. Both Gillian and Jamie suffer from severe amnesia. Their memories of events prior to being picked up in Siberia lost in a mysterious mental fog. 2 years ago,
Dad,
in an attempt to rebuild their marriage, Jamie and Gillian separate. Following extensive special military training, Gillian is ordered to report to Neo Kobe City as a junker. Effective today.
He's a junker.
Go find out.
Japanese underground neo kinetic.
I was going to say underwear.
Elimination Ranger.
Okay. All right.
It's different in Japan.
And wait, are you, you're actually serious?
The Konami Omni building.
I guess you just made that up. Right next to the Somi headquarters.
Uh-huh.
And ask.
Someday they'll release Act 3 for Snatcher. Just keep holding it out. It's coming.
Because they haven't had their budget slashed in the last year.
Well, I guess on the PC 88 and the MSX version, they didn't have an Act 3.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So they literally
added stuff for the
All right, here we are at Junker headquarters.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yep.
Straight up here are some verbs.
Yeah. Look, operator. She's beautiful. Rantal woman. Gillian.
Gillian's kind of a skeez.
Those people.
Not entirely appropriate.
Are they us?
The Junker recruiting ad.
What's
poster here. Let's look at this front pod.
Ourselves.
It's one of those pod type reception units. Operation is
one of
those.
We've got some out front.
Yeah.
Let's look at this camera.
It looks like a security camera.
Security camera. What are you thinking, Brad?
Let's investigate the operator. The government ad. So it's sort of weird because, like, you know, look and investigate seem they're two different things, but they seem like they could have been combined. Like it seems like that stuff could have been combined into one thing.
Well, investigate. Get back. Where
I investigated the poster, and now she's talking to me. So investigate kind of has a more of a
it's more like walk up to.
Sort of, kind of.
Kind of prime yourself to use.
And sometimes you have to select, like, the same thing multiple
times.
That's
a bit different.
Yeah.
Trigger stuff.
Yeah, so that he said something different this time.
I was not expecting this to be menu-driven, I'll say that.
I believe the kids call these games visual novels today.
Okay. Actually, I don't know what I was expecting. I mean, I knew it wasn't going to be a point-click game, but...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because when I think of, like, an adventure, you know, style, like, old computer adventure-style game, it's kind of a point-click adventure.
Right.
All right, so we tried to enter, and she's like, no, you can't do that. So now we have talk.
Oh, well, we tried.
I'm Gillian Seed. I've been assigned to Junker headquarters effective today.
Oh, you're Mr. Seed. Please forgive me. My name is Mika Slayton. I'm the administrative assistant and operator here at Junker headquarters. Very pleased to meet you.
Look at her.
Talking ass.
Investigator.
Look. Oh, I see.
Mm. Now I can't even talk anymore. It's like, we'll just... Yeah. All right, ask about numbers. Bioroid Snatcher Menace.
Bioroids.
So nobody knows where the Snatchers came from? Is that what I understood?
They just emerged from a plane crash one day.
I remember if that was spelled out. They do explain. Kind of, sort of.
Japan, but it's not Japan.
Oh,
I know what I mean.
I know what you mean.
What's up with you, though?
I just want to know if you can open the goddamn door for me.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, Japanese undercover hero kinetic elimination ranger.
Nice.
Several times, Snatchers have attacked the anti-Snatcher base.
Fucking stealths everywhere.
Mm-hmm. See that office. Let's go.
All right.
Mr. C.
Gillian's fine, and you can call me Gillian Mika.
It's Nest.
Okay, Gillian.
Gillian Mika.
I hope the maid will show you around headquarters.
There we go.
go. It's like better voiceover quality than a lot of the shit that was getting shoved on the CD-ROMs at that time. Like, it doesn't sound like it was recorded in a broom closet.
Oh, sure,
it.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
Fuck.
So, like, yeah, I mean, it's not.
It's like, the sample rate.
Thank you.
I guess so. I mean, you got feeling.
Like Santa Max did that, where if it had multiple responses, it was still.
It wouldn't darken. Just gray it out once you exhaust it.
What this game ultimately kind of falls down to during these sequences is a lot of trial and error. It's like keeping stuff till something happens.
Yeah.
I mean, luckily it gives you a lot of
range. We need to go get a gun first.
Ah, yes. Your blaster.
She'll give you one temporarily.
Oh. Made here. Bit of a lush.
Transmission arrived, not from Earth, but from Mars, from Tharsis. An impossible signal from an impossible source. Is this what we're searching for? Who's transmitting?
Also a match 3 puzzle game.
Yeah, it was thrilling.
Damn.
You were born for this.
Yeah, I was born to play whack-a-mole, yeah. Cyberspace whack-a-mole.
It's legal, it's cool.
Alright, 18. Alright. I forget where we find him.
In your room again, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe we have to go to the other areas first.
Yeah. John Just first name.
God damn it.
Thank you.
capacity.
40s.
Yeah.
That brown trench coat.
Here's my turbo cycle, also known as a car. Yeah, I know he hated it. I don't know if it was the actual evolution. I think it was like a limited release first, and then the producers were like, nobody's gonna get this shit. Let's record some more stuff. There are like five different movies. Yeah, I couldn't even tell you the best one. Alright, there's so many of them. We're at the abandoned factory.
Yep.
Let's look at it.
Yep.
Okay. Appears to be abandoned. Let's look at the sky. Quite dark.
It's dark.
Maybe a storm coming. What's going on? No, let's... Well...
Also abandoned.
Yeah. Let's investigate. Motion detector. The idea of calling a Metal Gear metal is really
weirding me.
Weird. Alright. Motion detector. Nothing. Investigate the building.
Thank you.
to Reading. So we can't do that here. Keep on keeping on. Advance.
Retreat.
We have perfected.
Strengthens
that area, right?
Exactly. Just retrace your steps.
Yeah.
I let
Still dead.
Thank you.
for the horror movie. No, because it's the way to be a hero, it only just becomes advanced next season. I feel like this is where the next big thing happens, but it does not happen until you try to leave and can leave, so, alright, you are correct.
Terrorists.
They don't have buffalo.
Little John.
Oh, shit. Urgently trying to get away from the time bomb, but I totally forgot there was a time bomb.
Metal Gear with us.
Ah, yes. Private paintings.
Designed for the Ektomi. Nobody has them but us.
Is this the preferred version for kind of nostalgia?
I mean, for me, I think, yeah. I think you'll find a lot of people.
I was looking for just like more quality graphics. Saturn version is better.
Well, it was more translated.
They never came out here.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, they weren't translated.
This encapsulates the treasure experience.
I think so. Inches, huh?